music would not exist without composers. I would also say that without performance, music would not be known as well. But composers are the sources from which music is born. And to work next to them is like drinking pure water. Letters is a book of memories, a tribute to life and friendship. It is a cycle of 25 short, I would say, stories. And I consider this as a proof that behind music there are human relationships and the energy between people, the energy they share during collaboration and during their life remains in the music. Every musical work has a connection with some circumstances, a particular genesis. But I leave the facts and the analysis to the historians and musicologists. What I can really speak about is what is the mission of a musician in front of a work, of a musical work. Which is at the same time a personal expression of an extraordinary man, an expression made of private dedications to friends, and also an extraordinary legacy related to the world of theater and cinema. The music of Ghia Kancheli crossed my life some years ago. And after that, I had the desire to go in front of the microphones and record his piece for violin and piano called Time and Again, which was published on CD worldwide by Brilliant Classics. I played that piece together with the Italian pianist Marco Venturi. So in that occasion I discovered that for my particular sensitivity and attitude, for my nature, I was already connected to Cancelli's music. And after Ghia Kancheli listened to the recording of Time and Again, he also noticed that connection. Every time I go to the stage, I wonder what is the role of an interpreter. I always am in the middle between the composer and the listener. So, how can I serve the reason of the music? Music for me is not showing abilities or entertaining people, but is sharing values, ideas, emotions. But which values or emotions can we really express except those we truly feel? If you decide every detail of your playing before playing, or you don't do it at all, you do basically the same mistake. You betray the sense of music. Both if you are proud of not having added any personal vision, and also using the music only to show yourself. This music stands in a way in the middle for me. Sometimes you don't have to do anything else than play exactly what is written without adding anything personal. Somewhere else, like an actor, since this music has inside the trace of drama, you have at the same time to get into the character and to get into your soul. It was really amazing to live this sort of travel in the past, recalling friends and bringing to a new life many corners of the memory. I am talking about a memory which is not only personal, but also collective, a very important part of the Georgian culture and of Georgian collective identity. And this was so strong for me to feel in the Rustaveli Theater, in the sold-out Rustaveli Theater, a place where most of the played story was born. Every letter had applauses at the beginning and at the end, because people followed the concert with so much enthusiasm, joining live the dedications. But I would like also to look further this. Letters to Friends, in my opinion, is not only a personal project, but a music that speaks to everyone. Not only a Georgian repertoire, but an universal heritage. Thank you. My partners on stage was the fantastic Georgian Strings, which I am grateful to for their support and sound, and the incredible conductor Nico Racivelli. Together we shared a great tribute to music, art and friendship, browsing human emotions like joy, sadness, love, and also some spontaneous irony on stage. We simply did it.